In this tutorial, we will create a basic sparks effect by using the Billboard Renderer's Axis Align billboarding mode. First, we will create an effect from the context menu. Right-click, hover over New Effect, and click FX Simple. Rename the effect to Sparks, or something similar, and then click Accept. This will create a basic template for us to start working with. Double-click the Particle Layer node and delete all of the nodes connected to the Physics node so we can start from scratch. You can either select all of the nodes and press the Delete key on the keyboard, or you can right-click and find the Delete option in the menu. Then, left-click on the position pin of the Physics node and drag. After releasing, type in the search bar, Local Position to World, and place the node. Afterwards, left-click on the Velocity pin and add a Local Direction to World node. Click and drag the Direction pin and add a VRAN node. If you ever want to add a node between two pre-existing nodes, simply create enough space and right-click on the linking line and select Insert Node. Alternatively, you can hover over the link and press Control Space. We will add a multiplier node in between the VRAN and Local Direction to World node. The multiplier node has two pins, value A and value B, which are two values being multiplied together. We will add more randomness to the direction of our sparks by adding a random node to the value B pin of the multiplier node. The random node will randomly generate a number between the minimum and maximum defined values we set. For this example, we will create a float and set the minimum value to 8, and then we will create another float and set the maximum value to 12. Next, we will select the Billboard Renderer, and in the Properties panel under Billboarding Mode, we will select Axis Aligned. All of the particles will disappear because a velocity for the particles has not been defined. Select the Physics node, and under Visible Outputs, check Velocity. Then, connect the Physics node's Velocity pin to the Billboard's Axis pin. You should see particles on your screen once again. The particles are now elongated due to how fast they are moving. When dealing with particle systems that are moving very fast, it helps to slow down the speed of the simulation in order to properly see what is going on. To do this, in the viewport, under Sim Speed, you can move the slider left to right. In order to get back to the normal speed of the particle system, right-click and choose the 1x option. Going back to our billboard, we will now change the size of the particles to 0.03. Next, we will insert another multiplier node in between the physics and billboard velocity pins. Add a float to the value B pin of the multiplier node and set the float value to 0.1. This will reduce the elongation of the particles. Then, we will link a random node to our life node and set the minimum value to be 0.1 and the maximum value to be 0.3. This will randomize the life of the particles so they appear to be even more varied. The next thing we will do is change the color of the particles. When creating a new billboard renderer, all of the pins are displayed in the node graph by default. However, in this template, most of them have been hidden. In order to display the color pin in the graph, in the Properties panel, under Color, select the Eye icon. A new pin will appear on the billboard node in the node graph now. Create a new color node and select a shade of orange with the color picker. Increase the value shift in order to simulate a glowing effect. Return to the root menu and select the multiplier node. In the Properties panel, under Emission, change the duration to 0.05 and the spawn count mode to total particle count. The particle system is restarting too often now. In order to fix this, we will change the duration of the loop to 1 and click the Loop button. This will make the system restart every second. In order to have multiple instances of this particle system, we can turn on the viewport's grid and then place our cursor where we want the new particle system instance to spawn and press the spacebar. You can create several of those on the grid. In order to pan in the viewport, you can press the middle mouse button on your mouse. You can also use the button to zoom in and out of the scene by scrolling up and down. In order to rotate, you can press the Alt button and left click. This is the base effect. If you like, you can stop here. We will go over some steps that you can follow to make the effect look more polished. First, we will go back to the root graph and select the multiplier node. In the emission section, under spawn count, we will change the value to be anywhere between 50 to 100. Next, we will go to the layer node graph and change the random values that determine the particle system's life. Set the minimum value to 0.3 and set the maximum value to 1. Afterwards, select the billboard and under size, change the value to be 0.05. Then, delete the color node and create a curve over time node and link a curve node to it. Double-click the curve node and add 4 dimensions to the curve. In order to move one curve at a time, we can toggle the curves on and off at the top left corner of the curve editor. Alternatively, you can also use the color picker if you prefer. For a more realistic spark effect, we want the particles to start out a pale yellow or orange with a full alpha, then transition to a saturated orange or red, and finally, fade out with an alpha of 0. The preview of the color of the curves is located at the bottom of the curve editor. This is our final color curve for your reference. Once you have completed this step, you should have something that looks like this.